These speedrun attempts are streamed live and daily to my Twitch channel. If you're looking for more content between my uploads, you can count on me being there every evening through the graveyard shift. To check it out, click the link at the top of the description, and I might even be live trying to beat this time as you're watching this video. Enjoy. They gotta charge you an extra dollar on mobile to pay the App Store. It's pretty cringe. So yeah, only subscribe on desktop. It's pretty cringe. Not very gamer. This game makes you want to play Truth or Square. Yeah, eating a rare fillet with caviar makes me want to fucking eat my own shit out of the toilet. That's basically what you just said to me. Makes me want to get on my knees and fucking eat someone else's shit out of a public restroom. This game makes me want to play something that is complete fucking garbage, but vaguely resembles it. I'm gonna fucking eat some fucking shit. What's up, Alex? Thanks, Chicago, for the 3 months. It looks better. But it's not much better. Yeah, you came into me talking about gobbling my own shit out of a public restroom toilet. Lights, camera, pants is all right. Decent game. One of the few decent SpongeBob games.
Now I can wear 4 pairs of underwear. This is great.
What's up? Honestly, the more I play that game, the less I like it.
Down.
Gets very repetitive. Like, the actual playing part. I appreciate the art style. And, like, the crafting that went into the Bikini Bottom, you know? Making it feel like the show. The voice acting is good. Everything is great. Except the fact that some of the mini-games are kind of boring. And the fact that everything runs on a timer is kind of dumb. Doesn't really make much sense for all the mini-games. If there were like a fixed version of that game, it could be great though. Had a lot of potential. This game makes me want to play Revenge of the Flying Dutchman. I just love to fucking play worse versions of games that I'm already playing. Let's fucking go. Thank you. 9 to 5. Once it hits 5, though, finish the attempt I'm on, and then, bedtime. Well, that's just how speedrunning works, man. As soon as you get a run, like, people are gonna study it and figure out how to beat it. In a game that's that unoptimized, like... I mean, you essentially found a new strat during a run, so, like, they're gonna see that shit and try to replicate it. Next thing you know, your time is beaten. Like... Imagine, like, I just randomly, like, found a strat in this run that, like, saved, like, 5 minutes or something like that. And I'm like, oh, this run's unbeatable. And then, next thing you know, somebody beats it because they watch the run and they figure out how to replicate it. That's how it goes. Nah, I think that was just, like, the first time that happened where they just warped into the room. Lab door skip. We're going back to 2012 with our game knowledge, boys. Let's go. My cat's snoring. I can hear him from down here. It's really not. But, yeah. Movie is more of a sequel to this game than Truth or Square is. That's really disappointing. That's really disappointing, because I had it and I just fucking jumped too early. It's so dumb. So I just have to get the same fucking- I have to get note jump twice in the same run. Alright. Yeah, I jumped a frame early. On the first one. This one, I jumped a frame late, but yeah. It is what it is. Oops. Yeah, Creature from the Krusty Krab was... below average, but still fine. Passable. I think that your depth perception was a little bit off there. The blue note that was below me was on a different track. Like, the one on the track that I was aiming for, I couldn't have reached. One frame. The boost only works on one frame. Morning. No, the most annoying trick in the history of the game is one tiki. Actually, no. The Poseidon clip with lag was the worst shit ever until they found the new strat. But it's a pretty obscure strat anyway. Like, over the course of my time playing, the strat that's annoyed me the most is definitely one tiki. Ouch. Yeah, you have like a 2-frame window for the second jump, but one still loses more time than the other. I mean, at the level I'm playing, it does, but like when you're new, you know, it's not like you have to do all this shit. This game has just evolved way faster than most games would in the span of 5 years, so we're just doing all sorts of ridiculous shit now. Because we never stopped pushing it. Really? Yeah.
So.
That's not how this game works, man. Like, Mario 64 has a loading zone to its final fight. This doesn't have a loading zone. It's, like, just because, like, you're comparing apples to oranges, you know? Like, just because you can skip to the final fight in Mario 64 doesn't make it more or less optimized in a game where you can't physically do that. Like, it's not like we don't know how to clip into the door. There's just nothing behind it. Yeah, exactly. Just happens to be that you can skip the endless staircase. Like, even if you could skip, like...
Looks like the robot
even if...
left itself vulnerable.
I'm not explaining this straight away.
Great Barrier Reef.
You can clip behind the lab door, but there's nothing behind it. Yeah. Like, when people who watch the documentary come in here and they're like, yo, did you guys ever find lab door skip? Like, it's not a real thing. It's a joke. Because, like, obviously, like, it was never found, because it's not how the game works. I mean, what we would need is a way to, like, underflow the spatula counter so you could just have 75 and enter. That would be the only way that we'd be able to do it. Or, like, some kind of, like, pause menu storage cheese.
The robot's losing its head! What a shocking takedown by Patrick!
Those are the only two ways I can see it happening. Oh, it would suck, but yeah. It'd be a meme. I don't think so. Because there are 10 Patrick trades. There are like 10 Patrick trades, but after 8, you get the text where it tells you that, like... gives you like a different text, I don't know. Underflowing socks would still save a lot of fucking time though.
Wow, I've never seen such an electrifying match.
Yeah. Just watch Cheap Percent, see how great that run is. Yeah, exactly. There's only one Patrick, but there are technically 10 you could trade. And, for the 10, it's like, after 8, it stops you, so it doesn't even matter. Need like some kind of like text manipulation.
What an opening for a guy literally filled with openings. Oh, what an uppercut. Nice move by SpongeBob. This match is just about over.
I mean, I guess the best way to put it is like the reason why we're not skipping the 75 spatula door is the same reason why they're not skipping to Corona Mountain in Mario Sunshine. There's just no loading trigger. Also, Shogi, thank you for the 2 months. Thank you. It's already been a month, damn. Well, it's only a couple of weeks, but yeah. I do appreciate that, Twitch Prime. Also, I really should have used the bathroom before I got into this run. Are you fucking kidding? Thanks, ma'am. I think the next thing that's going to break this game is figuring out shared memory values across levels. Like, interpreting memory values and, like, manipulating them across levels. Because we know that, at least based with CCA, there are some memory values that don't clear immediately when you when you go to another level. So, there's definitely a potential for weird shit. Just unlock a bunch of levels and do a bunch of fucking SRM. Real. What are you doing your next runs, Alex? You just working on finding stuff right now, or busy with shit? Gotcha. Oh, right, yeah. I wouldn't be motivated to speedrun if that were the thing.
Feeling this didn't work.
Okay, never mind.
Cool.
CCA was a thing way before Rehydrated was a thing.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
But like, in Rehydrated it just happens on its own because the game is just, yeah. That's the only tech that transferred, and it's like not even tech, it's just the game does it.
Well, all the security.
Obviously, we're a lot, you know, farther ahead than that. No jump is newly implemented. But not, like, new, as in, like, newly found. I don't know. It's been known for a while, though. I believe that's been done.
Hello.
Yeah. I think he means specifically note jump, though. But yeah, that stuff's been known for a long time. What's up? It's been very mean to me today. As you can tell. Yeah. That's been known since, like, 2016. Actually, I'm sure even earlier than that. I'm sure Cole knew about that shit.
Welcome to
Tried to get some extra shinies, but didn't work out. Well, there is SPA and rehydrated, but it's not useful. Dude. Just really, really slow, but it does work. Did A-rated a long time ago, like 4 or 5 hours ago. We were at like 400, I think, before he raided. Like high 300s. Wow. Legendary. Oh, damn. Wow.
There's nothing like a smell of bubble in the morning.
Yeah.
SpongeBob's in for a rough ride!
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Great Barrier Reef!
Ow! Ow!
That's the ticket! Taking a beating out there.
Ow. 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 Ow.
Ow. Ow. I guess fight. Bob won't be
what
winning
is
that going
way?
To do to get SpongeBob unfrozen?
This is all level specials.
One more douse with that stuff, and SpongeBob will be back in the ring! Oh! That was a doozy! SpongeBob is back in the fight! Oh! That was a doozy!
I feel like a new sponge!
Dude, you can't be fucking serious, man.
Dizzy.
Extra spin and that shit. Awesome.
Money.
Thank you for the bits. We're gonna be cruise boosting very soon. Hopefully. Hopefully nothing crazy happens. Bunch.
Oh,
I don't even know what that fucking means, bro. What the fuck does that even mean? Being a gamer has something to do with that. Gaming? I actually got note jumped twice in this run. But I jumped a frame early after getting the first one, so I had to redo it. It was bullshit. Yeah, but like, PC ports back then were all fucked up, so. I don't know, man. If this game were ran on the PC version, I don't know if I would have gotten into speedrunning it. I was recording these on a laptop at the time. I don't know if I could have streamed and recorded at the same time. Well, I had a desktop, but I don't know. I don't know how history would have played out. Who knows? Man. Who knows if it would have evolved the same way? The same people would have gotten into it, you know? I feel like no matter what, as soon as I found this game, I feel like I would have figured out a way to make it work no matter what. I don't think I would have given up. Seeing as all the shit I've been through with this game, and I still don't give up. That's awesome. I don't see myself stopping anytime soon.
has met the Sponginator.
Dude, way too close. The last time I came close to quitting was like 4.5 years ago. I was also like new and inexperienced. I was, yeah. I was a freshman in college. I started right before I, like during the month before my finals. I was like winding down from my freshman year, pretty much. That was a good wait. Dude, are you fucking kidding me, man? Yeah, we just make a bunch of shit up. Ever seen Twitter? What all the woke shit is, just Americans making shit up. That's all it is. Reject Twitter, use iFunny.
Number one in the bikini bottom scavenger hunt. 3 years running. Thank you. Number one in the Bikini Bottom scavenger hunt. This year's money. Thank you.
Are they not coming? Fucking dipshits. That is so dumb.
Here we are.
That's horrifying. The reindeer and Bob face. Okay, Can you get in the box? Hey! Great. Great, man. Dude. Come on. So I have fucking no time save left. Awesome. Cool. Oh. My God, man. Now we really have nothing left. Oh my God, get me out of this fucking run already. Fuck this, man. Yeah, it's a lot better with, like, no jumping. And, the downtown early stuff. Alright, somehow we're still ahead. I don't know how the fuck we're still ahead, but yeah. Maybe the lag clip won't destroy our lives like it did in the last run. PB. Alright.
Oh, I'm quick!
It's fine, just get me out of here.
Money.
Thanks for the bits, man.
Oh, I'm quick.
Thanks, man. I like these types of pulls that don't impact the run. Dude, fuck that. Dude, fuck off. Are you kidding? Are you fucking kidding me? No! Why? Why? Literally, why? Fine. Yeah, we're losing time because my PB did a DCB. But, yeah. whatever. Well, I only did it because the ROM was basically dead if I didn't do the DCB, so, yeah.
And here we are,
just all level spatulas, I don't really care.
The robot better change tactics and fast! Will SpongeBob be able to neutralize the giant robot's brain?
Guest start.
Oh.
Enjoy your channel points.
Money.
Damn. I choked during and after the run. Okay. So that Sand Mountain thing, I just wanted to make sure I got that Larry slide. Because my setup was like a tiny bit off, I think.
SpongeBob, you did it!
What'd he do?
I lost half a minute. Between Dutchman's Graveyard and Sand Mountain, I lost like half a minute that I could have just saved. Yeah, obviously, 102 is possible. Doable, rather. Like, clearly it should go without saying, it's possible, but like, yeah, gonna keep going for a 102, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm stinky, I have to pee, I'm gonna take a shower and use the bathroom. To all 500 of you who came out here at almost 6 in the morning to watch this, thank you guys, and I'll see you next time, which will be tomorrow. It'll be tomorrow at 9 p.m. Or later today at 9 p.m.